One, two, three.
What was the one you were doing the other night?
Morning, Paul.
Good morning.
It's all yours. Tell them we're rolling. It's all yours.
In fact, we are rolling. It's just sweet and lovely.
Let It Be is an entirely different part of the Beatles story. The Beatles that we've grown up with were not the Beatles in Let It Be. They were changing.
Okay, turn over cameras.
Okay, do it again then. So, one, two, three, four. Two of us riding nowhere, spending
someone's in that 1 month, they not just wrote and recorded the songs that appeared on the Let It Be album, they were composing the majority of the Abbey Road songs. Plus, they were working on solo songs.
Yeah, one of the fascinating things about Let It Be, it was originally going to be a concert movie with the Beatles. But then after about 10 days, we're not doing a concert anymore. We're doing a documentary.
Just have one each time, two at the end.
To prepare for a concert film is one thing, and yet to make a documentary makes your mind work in a different way.
You know, we've just gone around like for an hour with nothing.
You'll notice the shot of Paul is looking down on him because I put a camera up in the gantry. It was, I thought, the appropriate choice to try to get them to reveal themselves insofar as they ever wanted to.
And you deserve enormous credit for having the insight to do that.
When all the broken-hearted people living in the world agree, there will be an answer, let it be.
I loved the four of them. I really felt love for them, like a director often feels love for an actor. I really cared for them. And also I knew what a difference they'd made to the world. They did bring joy to the world.
Let it be.
What is your feelings now seeing the restoration of your movie?
It really looks beautiful, and I think it's wonderful that Let It Be may have a new life in the sunshine.
Well, that's me finished.